Tear it down. Don't be afraid to tear it down. And some of you are so afraid to tear it down because you think if you tear it down, it'll never grow. You know what I'm saying? You'll feel like you'll never get back to that spot that you were at. Tear it down. And tear it down with joy. Tear that sucker down. I'm talking about with excitement. Be geeked up about tearing it down. Knowing that when you tear that sucker down and level it to the ground and build back up, that you're going to build something phenomenal. So don't be afraid to tear it down. Tear it down, my friend.
Today's show is brought to you by Organifi. Organifi is an organic superfood supplement line that makes quality, trusted nutrition convenient and accessible. Their most popular product, the green juice, solves the problem of juicing greens on the go. We all know that we need to get those fruits and greens and vegetables and all that in our diets, guys, and here's a quick and easy way to get it. You just add water, drink, and let your body soak up the benefits. Visit Organifi.com to learn more about an exciting offer for you, our podcast listeners. That's Organifi, O-R-G-A-N-I-F-I.com. Today's show is brought to you by HelloFresh. HelloFresh is a meal kit delivery service that shops, plans, and delivers step-by-step recipes and pre-measured ingredients so you can cook, eat, and enjoy. They offer a wide variety of chef-curated recipes that change every week. Sign up today. Get $80 off your first month by going to HelloFresh.com/success80 and use the promo code SUCCESS80, and that's success and the number 8080.
I wake up every single day. I am who I say I am, and I get what I get because I live in beast mode. Stop being gazelle. You're not average. You're not even good. You were born to be great.
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the extremely Bayesian sensation. And I'm thinking about pulling that title, and I'll tell y'all why. I'll tell y'all why in a minute. But welcome to the podcast. How's the weather over there, young Bayesian?
Hey, I think I'm 2 shades dark already, if that's possible. Okay. I don't know if it's possible, but I'm about 2 shades dark already.
Okay, and also I'm sitting here looking at Douglas' toes stretched out. Hey, watch that foot, man. He got that. His toes are extremely close to my shin. So we are actually in the new church and, you know, together doing a podcast face-to-face for once. So we don't get a chance to do this often, but Douglas is in the building.
What up, y'all? What up, man? Yeah, I'm blessed. I'm going to just let the podcast go because y'all know. Right now, no words, but I do remember a t-shirt in 2019 that says execute, execute, execute. Those are the goals for 2019, and we just executed.
Yeah, no, we definitely did, man. Karl, you missed it. You were here in spirit, man, but we opened up the church yesterday, man. Let me tell you something. I should say Saturday. I wasn't here. I was in D.C. on Saturday, but I flew in and got a chance to be here for the full festivity day. Here, you know, on the campus of APOC Ministries, and it is a campus, man, and it was beautiful, Karl, man. We had games set up, basketball courts, kickball games, and right now I'm actually looking at one of the demise of the kickball game. If anybody watched IG stories, you saw the hip hop preacher. Did y'all win? Did y'all get the win?
We got the W. Okay. We did get the W. This is the third year in a row where the old heads against the young adults and the kids. We got the dub.
And it was not without paying a price. Douglas is over here. He called me. He said, hey, we're going to do the podcast, but can you bring me an Ace bandage? I said, uh-oh, what's going on? And so let me tell you something. This is crazy. Me and E was talking about it before we jumped on the podcast, man. When you start getting old, your body it will not perform the same way it used to perform. I'm like, okay, Eden got injured in a kickball incident. I call myself because I'm in Michigan. I'm like, yo, I don't want to fall off my workout regimen. Let me just go on up to the tennis courts. You know, run a little bit, get a little jog in. So, Karl, you wasn't here, but what was that, 3 days ago? Right before we left the D.C., my knee swole up. So I had ice, elevate. Let me tell you something. This is how you know I'm old. I learned a whole new term. It's called RICE. It's rest, ice, compression, elevate, right? So, yeah. So, but I got back. So before we left the D.C., I was solid, right? So then I came back from D.C. He got in the kickball game. I already knew. I was just coming off a injury. So I was like, no, I'm good. I'm just going to watch. He was out there dancing, Fast Shoes Willie. He was making it happen. And let me tell you something. I'm looking at a hurt man right now. He got the knee bandaged up. His toes look like they swollen up. You know what I'm saying? It's a rough time. Douglas, tell us about the injury.
Oh, first of all, let me tell y'all about the dub, right, which is very important. I was the starting pitcher, the closing pitcher. I was everything, right? But no, we had a blast, man. You know, I never want to be one of those pastors where people just know you from preaching. You know what I'm saying? You just preachy. You know, they only know you from Bible study, you know, or teaching from the pulpit. I want to be one of those pastors where kids remember, you know, like for real, we did some fun stuff together. I came to their school. I went to their games. We played games together. So we had a blast, man. But, you know, Jay, first of all, I know Jay going to get pissed, but I struck him out in kickball. You know what I'm saying? He had dishonored his father. And I told him, you out here dishonoring me, joking me. You will pay my, nothing good going to come to you until you do right by me. And we were supposed to do like, I think, 7 innings. Boog was like, let's go to 10, first to 10. You know what I'm saying? So we got to 10 before them. I think it was 10-4 at the end of the game. But I did pay a small price for the victory. I paid a small price. I don't know what happened to my ankle. Okay, I mean, my knee. All right, let me be honest. I know what happened to it. My body was like, we are almost 50. We go north and south. We don't go east and west. And I went east and west on a couple of those. You know, when you're the pitcher, you got to go all over the place. So a couple of times I went east and west, and my leg was like, this is what we're going to do then. Since you're going to be disobedient, we're going to sit you down for a couple of days. So if you're out there and you're over 45, well, if you're over 40, you ain't in good shape, okay? 40, you're in good shape. 45, if you're in good shape, try to limit the east and west.
Yeah, no, try to limit the east and west, and also don't jump, okay? That's another cardinal sin Douglas made. He was out there trying to jump and catch balls. But nonetheless, y'all got the victory, so I guess all is well that ends well. But we really, this is Karl's podcast, okay? This is about Karl. So now I'm mad because, okay, as you notice, for those of you who are, I'd say, not lifetime listeners, but at least been rocking with us for a year or two, remember the last time Karl was in Barbados, we also had another special guest on the podcast, the Bayesian chicken, okay? The Bayesian rooster was outside. But Karl, I don't hear any chickens, any roosters outside, so
not this time.
Don't catch us up. What's going on out there in the dose?
Yeah, so let me set the whole picture up. So we are in Barbados for the next, I want to say, 20 plus days, close to a month. And it just, the way it worked out, I had a wedding, like this, the guy that got married, he's like a brother. Like his grandmother lived next door to my grandmother. So we were, you know, we were together pretty much our whole lives growing up. You guys heard me talk about my grandmother that passed a couple months ago. Like it was next door to her that, you know, he was there. So he was getting married. I was the best man. So that wedding was on Saturday, the exact same day, of course, as the same weekend as the APOC grand opening. So tough. I had to miss that. But so here nonetheless. And then within maybe a week or two of finding out about this wedding, there's another real good friend of ours, weirdly enough, from Barbados that we met his family in Michigan, though. His daughter is getting married in Barbados on the 27th or 28th of this month. So my wife was like, dude, I'm off. The kids are off. You pretty much work anywhere with Wi-Fi. I think it's a no-brainer. We're going to Barbados and we're going to spend the whole month. And at first it was kind of you know, we're I don't know that that's something that we do, but and like, for real, that's the whole point of where I am right now, like, as we talk on this podcast. Like, that's not what we did. Let me change that. And I mentioned it before, like, earlier in the year, I talked about how, you know, you got to create the life that you want. You know what I mean? Like, what is it that's valuable to you? And I've always enjoyed travel, man. Like, that's something with my family. Like, I love traveling with my family. I like the exposure. I like the education that you get. And the big thing for me, man, is just being able to come back here with my family. And this time, though, she's referencing now. So that was the backdrop. This time, my wife and I decided we're not going to do it the way we usually do it. My parents have a house here. You know what I mean? So we grew up in Barbados. Tamisha's family, you know, they're still here. So we'd usually come back and stay with relatives, that kind of stuff. And this time we were thinking like, man, honestly, we just need to do something different. And it's not a matter of, it's not a matter of how it looks to anybody. Listen to what I'm saying closely, because, you know, there are people that anticipate you got to come and stay here and you got to come visit and all that. It's not an issue of how anybody feels. This is my family and this is how we want to do it. And we decided we're going to do it's similar to Airbnb. It's called VRBO. I hadn't heard nothing about it.
Barbados Airbnb. You know what I'm saying? BRB.
Right, pretty much.
Barbados Beds.
But it's one of the VR vacation rentals.
You said VRB. I got you. Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
So anyway, we just decided to do that. And dude, we have a house on the far south side of the island, and far on the island, but on the south side, overlooking the ocean. Hey, let me say it like this. I'll get it like this. We got a one-bedroom apartment over here in Barbados. It just happened to be close to the ocean.
No doubt.
And it happened to have a swimming pool. And I'll be real. Like, this is not something that I'm like, today is I remember when you transitioned to, like, showing the rooms that you were going into and all that. And at first, I was uncomfortable. This weekend, this week, this month, this is my transition point.
Let me see some photos, like, I need some photos.
I already FaceTimed.
It's coming. But the reason why, and I get it, E, for you, of course, you know, my journey's different. But for me, it's like, man, I am one of the people, like, you know, same thing. Like, I'm that S type we talked about with the assessment. And it's like, I'm making sure everybody's around. Okay, and I want to, like, fit in. So I don't want, you know, I don't want to show what I'm doing. I'm not, y'all see, I don't really have no social media like that. But the huge part that's happening this trip is, listen to what I'm saying. My parents are here. I just showed, C called me, my dad outside sitting on a chair in front of the pool, shirt off, just relaxing. My mom is here. Listen to, my brother is here with his two kids. So my kids are getting to play with their two cousins, almost identical ages. Then Tamisha's mother is up here. Tamisha's niece is also up here. We had some of Tamisha's friends come over yesterday. And here's the key part for me, and it hit me yesterday. I said it yesterday, I'm not going back to the place where I grew up. Yeah. Not because anything is wrong with it, but I'm grown up now. There's no reason for me to go back and stay at a place where I grew up, unless I'm going to enhance that place. It's not just, like, it's what it was when I grew up. Why am I going back?
Call Boog for me. He just stayed with me for 30 days. Call Boog.
You see what I'm saying? Like, what am I doing going back to this place that I grew up in when I'm grown and I'm coming back with a family? Like, the place was big enough for me, my brother, and my parents. Like, we all can't come back and stay here no more. Like, it don't even make sense. But it's something that we did up until this point. And see, what's huge right now, okay, you know, my wife and I made a decision, but look at the impact that it's having on my parents. Look at on everybody that's going to go through it. Like, my brother, his kids, like, they wake up in the morning, see, and I'm talking about they're putting on swim clothes, like, before breakfast. Like, that's the kind of life that they're exposed to right now. And they're sitting like, man, like, this is all a result of my wife and I just saying, let's do something different. Let's change this up. And I want people to understand, I'm not on no cost. Literally, if I were to sit down and figure out what it costed, I probably wouldn't have done it. Literally, like, I'm just being real. Like, I never saw money like this before. But I'm not on cost. I'm on what experiences, what is this going to initiate for my family moving forward? Because listen to what I'm saying, there's no going back.
Everybody got the one-bedroom swimming pool. You know what I'm saying? I got to step up my
one-bedroom apartment. You use the right language. One-bedroom apartment. One-bedroom apartment. Stay consistent with the podcast. Right.
One-bedroom apartment. Swimming pool. Yeah. Do this for me, though, bro. Because what you just said was important. Yep. And I'm putting you on the spot, so... You know, you may be able to do it, may not, but give me two or three things that you think you had to do, you know, because you're talking like, yo, E, I'm them. So if they're listening, they can't go, E a unicorn. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't do it. You just said it, like, yo, I'm y'all. And now I'm doing it. Give me two or three things that immediately somebody who's afraid to come to the dark side. You know what I'm saying? They're afraid to come to the dark side. You know, they're afraid to really live the dream and not just talk about it, but actually like wake up to it every day. So tell me, what are three steps that you had to take to make that happen?
So the biggest one, I'll say this is the first one and the biggest one. I can't take any credit for this. And see, I actually intend to start the podcast this way, but I want to thank both of you. Like, that's the biggest one. Who you connected to? Like, for real, for real. Like, we started this thing, what, 12, 15, how many ever years ago? And the environment that y'all both set was an environment that you didn't take anything less than, you know, your best. It didn't have to be excellence. Hear my language closely. It didn't have to be excellence, but it was your best at the time. That's the environment, E, that UNC created around me. I'm sure I added to it, but you guys initiated. I came into something that you guys had established. So, like, publicly, like, I tell you guys, but, like, for real, I want to hear people, let me say it, like, I love you guys and I appreciate what you've done, because that is what the catalyst is for this entire thing for my family. So that's one. But I guess bit by bit, you get Kevin Garnett, not Kevin Durant. You get tired of losing, man. Like, I keep watching my parents. It was a huge part for me. Look around you. Look at your family. Let me talk to the people. Like, look at your family. Look around you and look at the stuff that's going on. I watched my parents do exactly what they were supposed to do. My brother do exactly what he's supposed to do in terms of going to school, getting an education, you work a job. And for my parents, I saw where it ended up. It was not this. Listen to what I'm saying. My parents are not doing this and bringing the family along. They're not doing that. Why? They followed the system. I watched my brother go and get a PhD in organic chemistry. My brother's a slightly different case, but still, he's not, like, his education, the system then put him in a place where, you know, he's free to do what he wants to. He still has to do, you know, he still has obligations. And I'm saying, like, I got tired of watching my family and realizing that, like, yo, if we keep doing what we're doing, it leads to the same place. I don't know how, like, we joke and talk about, you know, when we look at the Bible, even look at the Israelites and say, these people were dumb. God was with them. Well, we doing the same thing. Like, you looking around, I watched 2-3 generations grow up in the same house, the same, you know, environment, the same mindset, the same spending habits, the same car, the same stuff. But somehow you think it's going to work out different for you. So I just got tired of watching that and watching, like, yo, something's got to be different. Now, the biggest piece, and y'all know how y'all been following us for a minute, the biggest piece for real is, like, yo, you just got to put some of the work down. Like, the workaholic mindset for me, and I'm not even delivered from, like, this morning I got up and I was like, okay, Karl, like, I had to talk myself through it. You sent a text to the coaches group and you said, I'm about to spend time with my grandmother. I was like, yo, thank you. That was perfect timing, because I was sitting right there at that moment, like, yo, I want to do something real quick and check an email, but my family's downstairs. So I'm not even fully delivered from it yet, but you can't, E and C said it to me this entire time, you can't work and get there. Hear what I'm saying closely. You can't work your way to it. I'm not saying you're not working hard, but you can't work your way to this. There's a point in time where you have to delegate. You got to duplicate yourself. You got to create systems around you that stuff can go on in your absence, because at some point you're going to be gone anyway. You can't do it forever. Somebody emailed me after the call yesterday, E, with the same thing. Like, yo, how did you do it? And the first thing is, you got to have people around you that you can delegate and duplicate some of the stuff too. You can't take on the full responsibility and do this. And depending on what your goal is, you're stuck. If this is what you're trying to get to and you're trying to work, the two are not going to work. They can't coexist. It's one or the other. And chances are, if you're working and you're stuck in working, you're not going to get this to this level. And then the third one, just jump. The third one is just jump. Like, for real. Like, here's the funny part. What it cost was in the bank account as savings. And I'm being real. Like, we spent a bunch in the bank account not thinking about it, just jump. And what I'm learning from this is, whatever it costs to do it, we can figure out how to make it again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whatever it costs, it costs.
It costs. But what the experience I'm getting, trust me, I'm saying everybody in my family is on a whole different level right now. And even within my family, I guarantee we're going to look for a different stream of income within my family. Listen to what I'm saying. Like, outside of ETA, outside of anything else real estate that I'm doing, I'm guaranteeing you that my family now, because of the way they're exposed, we're going to look for a way to make this happen again. So because I've done it, I'm going to look for a way to do it again. You know what I'm saying? What's the old, it says, if it's nice, do it twice. Like, that's the reality of it. Just jump. Take the chance. It ain't life or death. Probably 90% of y'all had your bank account less than $1,000 before. You did it before. You did it before. I'm saying, like, if you're going to do it, don't do it on a car. Don't do it on something that's just, you know, the value is gone. Like, I'm telling y'all, the experience where my family is now, like, this is not going anywhere. My mother said the other day, like, she said it was hot one day. She was just outside sitting down. There was a breeze blowing. And she was like, yo, I felt like I was going to die. But she was like, I felt so at peace even if I was going to die, because I see where my family is. And if I'm not here, I see where they would be going. Dude, you hearing stuff like that in a matter of 3 days being here? Are you kidding me? So it's a no-brainer. Like the floodgates are open. Whatever I got to do to get back here. And I said before, yeah, at least once a quarter. Now I'm taking the limitation off. Whenever.
You feel me?
I'm taking it off. And hear what I'm saying closely. Not on no, we balling status. And it is we living right. status. Like I'm trying to live life. I left Lawrence's funeral. See, last Saturday. Not this one Saturday, just passed. But last Saturday, the guy that I talked about, 37 years old, he's gone. He impacted the world, you know, with his 37 years. But I want to do it in my 80 or 90. I don't want to be gone. Or if I'm gone, I want to make sure I lived all of it. I lived all. I ain't leaving nothing back. So yeah, I hope that answered your question, E. But yeah.
No. And that's what I, you know, asked. And that third one, I want you guys to really hear the third one. And I used to tell Karl this. It's weird. There's nothing wrong with saving. Well, I shouldn't say that. Stop saving and start investing. You know, saving is... Yeah, that's the minor leagues, like invest so you can have. But here's the thing I explain to people. Buy it. And again, like Karl said, we're not talking about like cars and just, you know, frivolous stuff. But buy it because once you buy it, it will force you to come up with the streams of income you need to come up with to make that your lifestyle. And I think that's what people do wrong, Karl. It's like, I'm going to wait 20, 30 years. It's like, no, you are so powerful as a human, but when you settle, you never see that power. But when you go get the crib, I never forget, I told Didi, like, the crib we living in, I'm like, let's get it. She like, we could barely afford it. I'm like, first of all, it's a 30-year mortgage. Do you think we're going to be in the same place financially today, 30 years from now? Like, do you really believe that I'm that whack? Like, do you believe that? Like, I got plans. And so... What happened was in about 5 years, stuff changed. And now she like, shoot, we should have got a bigger house. I'm like, we should have. So now she trying to buy a $20,000 couch and put new wood and stuff in the one we got because it's like, shoot, I want to do something. I'm like, okay, cool. So now let's go find our one bedroom apartment with a swimming pool. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, but I think you know what's crazy, and Karl, you probably feel me, you know, even though we grew up in different situations, what you have to understand is that mindset is completely contradictory to everything else you've been taught.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You always taught to be safe, you know, to you know, go under, you know, whatever your budget is and all of those things. And, you know, I think Maul, and maybe I'll try to get Maul on the phone here in a second and see if we can get him to chime in. But Maul was actually the first one I ever heard say, like, to buy that. But you know what's so funny, E? You know, I got the kids here in Michigan with me. And so, you know, anytime we here, we go buy MSU gear, right? And so I went over to, what is it, Campus Den or something like that in the mall like that. So we went into the mall, Karl, and they literally had, it was 50% off the entire store. I'm talking about, like, everything. And you know me, I buy state gear, you know, take back to Georgia so we can rep. So it was 50% off the entire store. And you know what's funny? It was like some sweet kid stuff, but it was all like a little too big for Trey. And so Candace was like, guys, it's a little big. And you know what I told her?
Grow into it.
Yeah, he's going to grow into it. Mm. Like, but there wasn't. Okay, so let me try
catch
to say
it.
This.
Yeah, catch it.
Catch it.
I heard it.
I feel like doing East Penguin Walk. You know what I'm saying? I feel like doing the you missed what I just said. Okay. But there was the expectation, what I know for sure is that he's going to continue to grow. And I think sometimes we buy stuff that is, it better fit perfectly or maybe even a little too small. Because we like, yo, and so I guess and Karl, you're not the only one. The internal struggle, I mean, you know, for whatever, you know, you got, you know, approved for, you know, whatever you thought was your limit or, you know, that kind of thing. I guess, you know, you're saying don't take off. I ain't telling you to go buy no Maserati. Like, I don't want people to hear this wrong. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I do think that people listen to us, and I know that's a great responsibility that we have. And so I want to be able to say this in a way that you understand that we're not necessarily talking about you going out and buying the sweetest car on the lot or the biggest house you can buy. Like, oh, we only got approved for $400,000, but I'm going to take out another bank loan for another $600,000. That's not what we're saying. I think what we're saying is if you always live so conservatively If you always, you know, refuse to take a chance or invest, or like E said, just save and, you know, what happens, happens. I think what you, you know, Karl, what you're saying is so powerful that, yo, y'all live a middle class lifestyle, right? And you yeah. got the families just got conditioned to that. So it took one person to then take a leap and say, you know what? I'm not living the middle class lifestyle anymore. I'm going to take it to a whole nother level, and I'm going to, you know, venture out. And obviously for you, there's a few things that you had to do. Like, I mean, you know, we haven't done the full episode, but obviously you own property now. You're a real estate investor. Yeah. That's allowed you to do that. Like, do y'all understand how me and E sitting here looking at each other in our face when Karl is talking about spending his money and getting a... Karl is about the cheapest person you ever met next to Douglas. You know what I'm saying? I'm on the podcast with two of the tightest, you know, sun guns this world has ever seen. And so to hear you say that you, not only are you out in Barbados for a month, you know, and I saw, so Karl, maybe you take the video. Of course, me and Carl's de facto IG is the S2S podcast page. So Karl,
no doubt.
Make sure you take a video of, you know, the property, the place. I saw it on FaceTime this morning. I'm talking about, I could see, anytime you could see the pool and the ocean in one frame, you know you're doing it. And bro, I'm just so proud of you, because this literally, like, it just go to show you people can grow. Like, when, like, Karl, this is so far from who you are and what you, you know, what I would have expected from you based on your previous track record. Or like, Karl, like, look, we'll go stay in the basement of my auntie house with no AC to save a dollar. But now you see that by spending and by going to that level, you know, now not only does it drive you to keep that lifestyle, he always says, like, yo, the easy thing is, you know, having, you know, never having it, right? Like, if you cool, you cool. You know what I'm saying? You've been eating PB&J, you could just stick to it. But once you start eating steak and lobster, it, you get an acquired taste. I promise you, it can be tough going back. And so, E, why don't you say a word? I'm going to try to get Jamal on, because he actually talks about that as well. But why don't you enlighten us on that?
Yeah, no, I think what C said was just like, whoa, you know what I'm saying? Like, a taste for it, man, a taste for it. You know, so a lot of you guys see the grind, but what you don't know is when Didi and I, like, went to Dubai, that one year we all went to Hawaii, I got a taste for sitting on the balcony watching the sun rise. Me and C, the sun was rising. Our girls are still asleep, but we were sun rising and we kicking it. Like, hey, we talked about this. We dreamed of this. Now, remind you, this was like a house we rented in Hawaii. So it's not necessarily, you know what I'm saying? Like, our office space or our homes, it's just a property that we rented out, and we did it as a group. So it might've been four or five of us. So, you know, you put your little check in, four or five people, you put your check in, it's easy to do. But we sitting there talking about it. Then Didi, we watching the sun set as couples. We got the grill. You know what I'm saying? The grill there. Jamie cooking up a storm. Chuck then bought the grocery store. We got schnitzel, schnicky snacks. You know, we got everything. Jamie done made like four course meals. And it's just me and my wife, you know, the ETA crew, the APOC crew. We listening to music. We going down to the ocean. Yo, and when I tell y'all we met a couple, I mean, I'm not going to say no names, but we met a couple, you know, let's just say sports legends. It was like we knew, like, yo, if they stand here, and they weren't even staying where we were staying. They were staying in a nice resort, but they weren't even staying where we were staying. And when Didi got a taste of that, it was like, whoa, I can do this for a week. Like, not vacation, but I can live like this. I promise y'all, when I came back, y'all saw the grind. The grind got realer than it ever had been before. So as to C's point, and that's why I want you guys, as I said in the Wingstop commercial, taste it. You know what I'm saying? I want y'all to taste it, because what you're afraid to do is you're afraid to taste it, because you like, I don't want to taste that and have to go back to this life I'm living. No, I'm telling you to do that. I'm telling you to taste it. So when you go back to the life you live, you are disgusted with it. And again, I'm not saying it's like, I still live in the same property that I bought in 1996. You know what I'm saying? Like 2006. I'm not saying that I live in a different spot. I live in the same one, but I don't live the same lifestyle. I might live in the same house, but I don't live the same lifestyle. I may have the same property, but I'm all over the world now. So I'm not saying the house you live in is whack. Go get you a new house. I'm in the same crib. Love my crib. But I'm saying I don't live the same life that I lived in 2000. Yeah, the same experiences in 2006 that I live in 2019, totally different. So don't be afraid to taste it.
Yeah, no, that's big, man. And, you know, I think one of the things, you know, we can kind of transition to is, like you just talked about the shirt, execution. Yeah. You know, and as I see it, Karl, like, we came to this place, y'all, and we'll put up a video of not only Karl's retreat manor, but we'll put up a video now of the church and, you know, the inside of the church. And Karl, as I look at, you know, the church, and I mean, of course, I'm not here. So, when, you know, he's FaceTimes me all the time. But to come in and set foot in here and see it for myself, you know, to see the lights, to see the three different projectors, to see, you know, the conference room with the marble floors, it's like, yo, like, so many humans talk about what they're going to do. You know, you got great ideas, you got great visions, you have things that are in front of you, and you're so scared to pull the trigger. And what it's crazy, Karl, the only thing standing between you and living what he's talking about and living what Carl's talking about and getting you a one bedroom like I got is you just delivering on what you said you were going to do or taking a risk that you normally wouldn't take. Karl took, let me tell you something. Maul and Karl with the real estate investments has taken Karl's, not only, I'm not, bump the money. You know what I'm saying? Bump the money. I've seen Karl become more confident as a result of doing something outside the norm, right? Like doing something that was not in his comfort zone and having a win. I've seen the confidence grow. And so now you continue to execute. And now Karl on, you know what I'm saying? And look, listen. The best thing about it, you got your family there and they're looking at it. You know what I mean? Your family is actually seeing exactly what you said, you know, what you said you were going to do. And so putting them in a position like that is legendary.
Yeah. And I want to real quick, Karl, I want Karl to kind of talk to us about like, what's that like? You know what I'm saying? I want Karl to kind of talk about, because you heard Karl talk about, you know, what it's like for him. You know what I'm saying? But his mom was a teacher. His dad was a teacher. Both were teachers. And I want him to kind of talk to you about how he feels about, not how he feels, but about how his family feels. Let me tell y'all something. His father came to me the other day and was like, thank you. You know what I'm saying? I was like, wow. His father was like, Eric, thank you. You know what I'm saying? I was tripping. And he was like, yo, for real. Of course, Karl had to make this happen. But, you know, thank you for the environment, Eric. Thank you for, you know, just pouring into my son. Thank you for what you've done for us. And so I want to talk to Karl about his father. Like, I want to talk to Karl about how, you know, what being in that room, what I know what it did for you. I kind of heard what it did for his wife a little bit, not really, but a little bit. I want to know, what is it like for his father? What is his father saying? I know what his mom is saying, but when he talked about, Karl, when you talked about y'all going to come back and start industry, I want to know, what is that though, Karl? You know what I'm saying? Like, what is it? What's the conversation with your family? Like, what is your father saying? What is your brother saying? You know, maybe what your wife is saying? Like, what are they saying, Karl? That's what I want to know. What are they saying? And what do you think when they get back, how is it going to be different when they hit the, you know what I'm saying? When they hit the pavement in Michigan, what talk to us, Karl. What is that like?
So the night that my brother came, so we didn't tell him anything at all. You know, as far as he knew, he was right. Coming to the, you know, same house right. We grew up in. So we picked him up at the airport. And now instead of going the way we usually go, you know, we're going a completely different, listen to what I'm saying. Wow. We're going a different direction than the way we usually go physically. Mm. We ain't drive the way that we go to our house. We going like the catch opposite. It. Yeah, we go in the opposite direction. Physically, we're driving a different direction, not just, you know, like, wow. Anyway, so I just play it off. I'm like, hey, I got to go drop something off to a friend of Tamisha's real quick. You know, we going here. So the kid's in the car. You know, the kids can't hold water. So when we get close to Jordan Buster, all right, we home. And I just said to him, all right, look, Glenn, we staying somewhere different. And he was like, oh, okay, cool. Like, is it a friend of yours? Here's his question for us. Is it somebody that you knew? I was like, uh-uh. And I just got out the car. He's like, well, how? I was like, no, we just rented the spot. He's like, oh, okay. So probably within a couple, we came inside, of course, met the family, whatever. And he and I just kind of stood there and talked for a minute. And it was like, I'm talking about like a 15-minute conversation, but like 10, like maybe 10, 20 minutes after I went to lay down, he went to lay down because he came in pretty late. He was sending me, listen to what I'm saying closely, he was sending me articles on ways that, I think the article was titled, How to Best Use Your Money in Your 40s. Mm-hmm. Within a couple minutes of saying, of us getting here and having a conversation, it was like, how to best, so he literally came and laid down that night after walking into the spot, and mindset was like, oh, something clicked. He sent me an article on Facebook that very night, like I said, within... You see what I'm saying? My mother.
So you never said nothing to him about where y'all was going to stay?
Nothing. Not a single word. He thought it was going like to, right to the house. I straight up lied. Like, nope, I got to drop some off to Tamisha, to one of Tamisha's friends. And literally within a couple minutes of being in here, like the conversation was like, and again, I need, like, he don't know. Like, he don't know what's going on. I was like, yo, we just found a spot. Me and Tamisha got it. That end the conversation. But it led into us talking about, like, yo, we 40. He's 43. I'm about to be 40 in October. And it's like, you know, what do we do now? And from that conversation, it was like he started sending me articles of, you know, the 9 or 10 best ways to use money in your 40s or something like that. And it was, 9 of them was what we're talking about on this podcast. Like, take a risk, you know, invest, like stuff like that. Like, you got your savings account, whatever. But I was saying, our lines got crossed just now. I couldn't hear you. So I was talking. Eddie, you'll have to fix some of that. But I was saying the deepest part about this for me is that I got 3 generations here. Tamisha's mother is here. You know, my parents are here. They've never seen this part of the island. Me, Tamisha, have never seen it. And obviously my kids, my brother's kids, you know, they ain't grew up here, so they ain't seen it. But 3 generations are now seeing something that none of us had seen before. And chances are if my mother didn't see it, her mother didn't see it. You see what I'm saying? Again, we're talking about an island that has 300,000 people. See, it's smaller than Lansing. Like, it's 21 by 16 miles. Like, that's the extent of Barbados. By 16 miles, 166 square miles, something like that. And there's a part of it that we haven't seen, but I was saying, but yet there's a house next door to the one I'm in, and there's a one next door to that, and they all 1-bedroom apartments with pools, it looked like.
Right, right, all 1-bedroom apartments with pools.
Yeah, no question. There's one down the street.
Absolutely.
That got a walkway that goes down to the beach. You see what I'm saying? Like, yo, it exists for everybody, like everybody that wants it.
It's a house for you.
It exists for
you. It's a house for me, yep. And one for and you. All right, tell me about dad, though, real quick. I think we got Jamal. We got Jamal? Oh, okay. All right, we didn't get Jamal. All right, give me dad, though. I'm concerned about. I want to hear how the patriarch took this boy.
So my mother, and again, my dad's not super expressive. I guess I get a lot of it from him. He's just kind of laid back, low key, so he just kind of chill. But what my mom said to me, listen to this, and it's simple, but you'll understand. When we were, where were we? I want to say in the airport coming, we flew down to Fort Lauderdale and spent the night there. Cause I'm not, the way they do the flights now to be full is like, they'll fly us from Michigan to Miami, you know, somewhere in Florida. And we'll wait 8 hours and then, you know, fly out that evening. I'm like, I'm not about to do that with my kids. So we flew down, stayed in the hotel that night and then flew out the next day. So we didn't just have to be in the airport like all day. So simple, listen to what I'm saying. Simple. We're in the hotel and we're like, yo, what are we about to eat? And I'm like, all right, let's just see what they got. My dad went downstairs and ordered for everybody. He ain't asked nothing about no cost. He ain't asked nothing. He's like, what you want, what you want, what you want? He's like, Jordan, no, what do you want? Listen to what I'm saying. That's not how
left,
my family left
side.
Works.
Strong side. Left side of the menu.
Left side. Yep. So he literally, just in that, me making the step, like I see the shift already in my dad. He like, yo, forget all this. Yeah. Whatever y'all want, we about to get. It ain't that deep. It's not that deep. It's stuff. And I want people to really understand, like, yeah, we're talking about house, all that. But listen to my language. What you want, you can have. I love travel. I love this experience. It might not be deep for you, but whatever you want, it's possible. Like, I'm going after this. Listen to what I'm saying. I'm going after this. I want to travel. I want Christmas time. We'll be on a podcast and I'll be telling y'all, me and my family, somewhere else for another 3 or 4 weeks. Listen to what I'm saying. This ain't something that's going to be novel. I guarantee you, if I'm alive, somewhere in December, we'll be doing this again. And the only reason I'm saying December, not sooner, is because my wife is working. Right now, right now.
How she take it? What, I don't know if she said anything or not about the experience.
No, but her body says everything. If that, her body language is saying everything. Her mother is here. You get what I'm saying? Within 24 hours of us being here, her mother is up here staying with us. So I don't have to. She don't have to say anything. Want to
know how have the gifts been?
You don't have to answer that, Karl. You don't have to answer that.
No. The gifts have been, let's just put it this way. Mother Nature just didn't want the gifts to happen just yet.
Mother Nature got in the way of the gifts.
Let's just say.
Mother Nature got in the way
of the gifts. The gifts are free flowing as needed. Yeah.
I said, then you definitely have to go back.
Oh, for sure. Well, we got it. Well, it's smart. We got enough time. Okay, Mother good. Nature can't kill us for the whole month.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, we got plenty of time. But yeah, no, just again, people, I want you to hear this. Like, if it's what you desire, man, first of all, the desire didn't come from you. I'm not going to go there. That's a sermon. But if it's what you truly desire in your heart, it's there for you to have. You just got to go get it. Figure out the way to get it. And I'm not saying it's just going to be handed to you, but it's go there, though. Get it.
Regardless if it's going to be handed to you or
not. It is there.
If it's there for the taking and I know I can get it. See, that's the only thing I'm concerned about. Can I get the W? You feel what I'm saying? Like, I'm looking at little Coco, you know, tennis player, 15-year-old tennis player. You know, she qualified, then beat Venus, her idol. You know what I'm saying? So for me, I'm watching her, and I'm only watching her, Karl, because she whipping up on grown folk. So I know she can win. And that's it. As long as you know you can win, to me, that should be reason enough to play, because you can't win. There's an opportunity for you to win. So, yeah, no doubt. I just wanted to know that. I know she wanted to get back to the church execution, boy, but I just really wanted to know the impact is making. And it's just the first trip. There are many, many more to go. And I can't wait until you own that property, you know, so then when I want to go to the dose, I can go for free because she said I'm cheap.
Oh, no doubt. And Karl will own it soon, I guess. I guess, I want to know, obviously, this is a huge milestone marker for Karl, you know, and definitely wanted to spend some time on that, but also wanted to spend some time, you know, for you. Yesterday, we had walked out of Karl, E and I don't know what we were doing, but we were like maybe the last ones to leave out of the church. And the party was still going on. Everybody had the yellow shirts on, kickball games, basketball games. We had like slushy machines, just the whole nine. And I know bouncy house, right, exactly. My kids running crazy, you know, and E and I walked out, and he was like, wow, bro, like, we literally put this together. Like, this was, like, man, again, you know, on this podcast, we always reminisce back to when, but, like, this was, like, y'all understand, like, we started this, like, borrowing somebody's church, like, giving them, like, $500 and being like, yo, okay, we'll come in on the day y'all not in there. Like, this is where this dream was originated from, like, we didn't know who was coming with us. We didn't know how many people. I don't even think E was like, I'm good on being a pastor. Like, I don't even, you know what I mean? And to Karl have the, you know, church open up like this, you come in, the music blasting. We got Toby over the loudspeakers. The cookout is going on. Hot dogs, hamburgers, chicken, just the whole nine. And I you know, E came out and was like, wow, we put this together. And I think what you're talking about and the theme I think I hear today is, like, the difference between accepting the life that was given to you and just rolling with that and creating the life that you want for yourself. And so, you know, E, to create this particular life that you, you know, were hoping to create, you know, to have a church this close to your house, to have a ton of members now, to have, you know, kids being impacted by the message, to have a beautiful facility, you know, to have, you know, this beautiful land. And I'm telling you, Karl, I was in here and I was looking around. I was like, oh, this is only the beginning. Like, we got so much property. You can see the schools already. You can see the daycares. You can see the whole thing. And so, E, for you, so in terms of execution, you've done a lot in your, you know, personal life, your professional life. You know, you obviously, you know, reached the status, you know, that few will reach. Where does this rank number one, and kind of what's the feeling for you having opened this church and really, you know, kind of taking that thing to the next level?
Okay, so if you don't mind, see, we don't have time to get into it, but next week, see, I want to really dig into why some people execute and some people don't. Like, we got to dive into that next week, all right? But we only got a couple more minutes. So in these last couple minutes, let me just say, man, I am so humble. You know, man, we built a worship, you know, facility for God's people. You know, like, bruh, this is going to outlast us. You know, it's like we're going to be gone and people will be, you know, maybe they'll have a picture of us up. Maybe they won't, you know, but it'll be one of those things where it's like APOC started in whatever, church built in whatever, you know, and people coming in and out of this place for years and years to come saying, man, these guys started this from Michigan State University. Let's not talk about barn churches, from Michigan State University. So this ranks probably among Jalen being born, Jada being born, me getting married. You know what I'm saying? This is up there, you know? This is up there, man. This is up there, man. And it's the little stuff, guys. I had somebody from every arena, you know, every aspect of my life in that building. Detroit Center, there were rappers there. My grandma, somebody that was there before I was there. Look, guys, my biological father, somebody needs to hear this, in the building. My, you know what I'm saying? My grandma, meaning his mom, he's in the building. Wife, you know, my little great niece, probably. You know what I'm saying? In the building. Of course, my mom, my Aunt Wanda. You know, my cousin Brian that you read about in the book. Chicago. Little B ain't never been up here. In the building. All Didi's cousins, Didi's aunts, mom in the building, you know. My sister Nico in the building. Jalen, Jada in the building. You know what I'm saying? Like, for Boog to be in the building, because he young, Boog young. So he may, you know, Karl sometimes like have his own thing to do. And so he'll like, oh, okay, you know, good thing for y'all. But he was like, Dad, I'm staying the whole week because I want to be there, you know, for the event. So to have him, you know, his fiance, you know, in the building, all the pastors that supported me, you know, man, from the mud, Pastor Trice, you know, Tabernacle of David, Tabernacle. Yeah, Tabernacle. You know what I'm saying? Holland was there, you know, and they rep for the crew. Pastor Corey, you know, Pryor from Jackson was there. Man, everybody was there. Pastor Patterson, DeAndre Carter, you saw him in the building. Dr. Curry, Dr. Bonita Curry, our ace in the hole, our ace band-aid in life in the building. You know what I'm saying? I can go on and on. You know, I know I'm going to miss somebody. Don't nobody take offense to it. But Jamie, man, with the lights, how he did it, the sound system, how he did it, man, it just was unbelievable, incredible. You know, of course, my wife there, you know, you got TJ and his family there, the Arringtons there. I could go on and on, man. Mr. Quinney, you know, always in the building from the beginning, in the building. It just, man, was a blessing. Like I said, I know I'm missing somebody. Don't take it personal. I promise you, don't take it personal. I know you were there. Love you. The Cannoneers was in the building. And just to have all those people in the building. Then we had individuals that were from online, Karl, that have never been to the church. They only watch via online or on the prayer line. Amanda, of course, represented them, came up for BU. We had some BU members in the house. It was a night to remember tonight.
Yeah, no, and let me, since I'm the teacher in the podcast, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know me. I'm trying to make sure y'all get the nuggets. E and Karl on cloud nine. I'm trying to make sure y'all take some stuff home. So let's go. Let's talk about, and we don't have a ton of time. E said we got a bit shorter podcast today. E's wife is under the weather. She too has a bad wheel.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, Karl, you wasn't here, but she actually took it. Yeah, she was running. She saw a cousin. She was overcome with the Holy Spirit and forgot the curb was there and took a dive, which is not funny because she hurt for real. But what is funny now is watching E and Didi as a couple, you know, to walk around limping, but together they do have one, it's a solid pair of legs. And so, yeah, but no, D straight, man. So yeah, that could have been scary. Although D said she was going to sue the church. So we trying to figure out what kind of insurance we got right now. So if the first lady sued the church, we still going to be all right. All right. But you out there, you listening, you like, yo, I feel y'all, but I'm tired of hearing about y'all great lives. Okay. I noticed that myself, and Jamal all spoke at Millions Conference, right? Shout out to our homie Tiffany For an amazing conference, and thank you for letting us speak. It was over 2,000, you know, entrepreneurs in the building in attendance, and it was incredible just to see the energy in the room, right? But I noticed that, you know, separate of each other, we don't really consult each other about our presentations. And I do have a fair file, though. I'd probably go to that. But matter of fact, Karl, let me do the fair file first. You know what I'm saying? Before I get serious. Fair file. So, you know, Coco, old girl, was playing, right? The little mama was playing tennis, and I had to speak. So, like, let's say I speak at 2, and Coco was still playing, and they went into the third set. Fair file that my brothers, E and Jamal, was like, yo, C, just go down there and get I'm speaking in front of 2,000 people, and they were like, yo, just go get started. We'll be down there after the tennis match. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying, bruh. You think I don't need the moral support? I done watched E speak from stage 10 million times. Ain't never told him I'd be down later. But since Lil Mama was winning, they came down, you know, 20 minutes into my speech. But whatever, that's neither here nor there.
Go, Coco.
Right, exactly. So, but anyway, independent of each other, all of us ask the question, what do you want? Right. And so I'm going to slow down and teach for these last few minutes. We're on the podcast. What do you want? Like, what's the thing that you want? And then I said, and then in my presentation, I said, no. Like, what do you really want? Right. Because there was a time in my life where, like, if you asked me what I wanted, I would have said, I want to go to the NFL. Right. I was young. I want to go to the NFL. But I realized I didn't even like football like that. I loved what I thought football could bring me. Because what I really wanted was to be able to take my mom to Paris. What I really wanted was to be able to fly my folks all over the country and take them out of the country and do those things, right? Like, I wanted to be able to provide a life for my family that, you know, Karl is talking about, that E's talking about, right? And so I realized that what Maul said was, you've begun to worship the vehicle and not the actual destination, right? And so when you say, what do you want? I didn't want to go to the NFL. I wanted a particular lifestyle for my family. So really stop and ask yourself, okay, what do I want? Okay, here go the things that I want. This is how I want to live. Again, everybody doesn't have to say, I want to be a billionaire, or I want to do this, or I want to do that. Like, that doesn't necessarily have to be the goal. Although I told E several times now, we are going to make sure E's a billionaire, right? And I believe that. And so we just start putting that out in the atmosphere. And the reason is because I can see now what money brings. Understand something. Remember what I told you yesterday, E? I said, look, all of this is cool. All of this is great. This came as a result of our grind and getting to the bag. Like, don't get it twisted. Like, all this stuff, like, as much as we love God and we want to do ministry and cook hot dogs and hamburgers, this facility that y'all see still costs a grip. Like, we got to put money into this thing. And so when I say, what do you want? Don't feel bad if you say it's something financially. That's okay, you know, because the reason I say I want to make E a billionaire is because I know what a steward of the money he's going to be. And so that's our goal. So what do you want? Once you find out what you want, decide what is the vehicle that's going to take you there. Now, again, y'all know how I teach. I want you to have the big vision in front of you. I want you to have, I want a lake house. I want this particular car. I want this particular husband, this particular wife. I want this many kids. I want whatever it is you want. I want you to dream big, but then I also want you to dial it back to what you have to do today. I want you to dial it back to what you have to do the minute this podcast turns off. Is it starting to write the vision out? Is it researching an LLC? Like, some of y'all, if you would just go get an LLC, how much does an LLC cost, Karl? I don't know, $100.
It ain't, I don't think it's $100.
Okay, yeah. Less than $100. You can go get an LLC, go on Google, get yourself an LLC and put the company name, whatever your Smith Enterprise. Some of you are that close to getting the ball started, to moving and executing towards your dream. Don't get overwhelmed with the big task. Let me tell you something, E, and you tell me, we bought this place. I'm not going to lie. I walked in and was like, this is a pile of junk. Like, when we bought this place, like, we walked in, I'm like, bro, this is a pile of junk. And because I don't understand how construction work, nor do I have like construction vision, what I did was, E, I walked in, I said, this is, bruh, E, you got the vision. I guess you see it. I don't. Matter of fact, Jamal came, he saw the vision. I was walking through the rooms like, let me just shut up so I'm not a negative Nancy. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being real. And also, that's a nugget too. Right. Some of y'all just shut your mouth. Like, you trying to comment on what everybody else doing. I didn't see it, but I trusted in E enough to go, all right, cool, if this is what you want to do. Now, we got a great deal on the building, but I'm still like, okay, we take $300,000, go get busy doing something else, whatever. But he saw the vision and he made it happen. E, I'm assuming when you walked in, you saw the building and you saw what was possible, right? You probably saw the edifice. Is it edifice or edifice? Yeah, edifice. Yeah. You saw it. You, but at the same time, you knew the first thing we had to do was tear the whole thing down. You know what I'm saying? Like that before you could do anything else. And I think, man, we hear stuff and we watch Instagram and we look at Facebook and we do all of these things and you like, yo, I want a yacht and I want this and I want that. But the first thing we had to do was take a doggone hammer and start knocking walls down. Like that was step one. Before we got the fancy light, like, yo, everybody want the colorful lights. Everybody want the three projectors and the loud music. Like that's the stuff you could see. Like that's the stuff that's sexy. You like, oh Lord, this is killing them. But nobody wants to take the hammer and literally knock a hole in the wall to get started. And so I think if people were able to be excited about the big vision, right? We just opened a church. How long ago did we buy the church? 2-3 years ago?
2 years ago.
Okay, 2 years. We bought the church 2 years ago. Literally 2 years. Avery, three, doggone it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and she's been around for a minute. We bought the church 2 years ago. And yesterday, and you're hearing this, we're doing this on Monday, but the events was this weekend. So 2 years later, before we opened the church. Like, that was commitment. That was vision. That was execution on a whole nother level. And some of you wait and you wait and you wait and you wait. We could imagine today if we didn't execute, imagine us having this conversation and not doing the podcast here in the church. Because E and I are in the teen room right now. Matter of fact, we came in like we built a prayer room for the teens to come in. Right. And it just had a little bit more soundproof and we probably a little bit more blessed in here. But we're in the teen room right now. Imagine us doing this podcast, not here at the church, but in your basement going, man, you want to go look at properties when we finish here? You want to go look at it? You remember that property over on Saginaw? You think they still like, nah, man, we set out the vision. We talked about it. We figured out how much it was going to cost. We figured out how much we had, how much we needed to save, how much we needed to put up, how much we needed to invest. And then we started getting it cracking. And so for you out there, what do you want? What do you really want? What's the vehicle you're going to use to get you to that particular place? And then get started, get a hammer, doggone it, and knock that first wall down. And I'm telling you, something about momentum. Like, I remember, like, I'm not here, and so I hadn't been able to do as much. But something about, you know, one of the main things that we talked about when we bought the church was Diddy wanted the high ceilings. Wow. And so that was a huge deal for her. So I just remember when we finally got the ceiling, like, tore out. It still looked like a complete mess, but you could finally see a hole through the roof. And it was like, whoa, like, okay, that was momentum. Yeah. And a lot of you just refuse to get started. The momentum of getting it going is sometimes enough to carry you through. So it was all downhill once we got that done. So, E, I'll let you jump in. But, like, talk to the people who, like, yo, you still, like, you know, on the edge of the pool. And you, like, one, two. And you just can't muster up either the courage or the gumption or the drive or the dedication just to jump in and figure it out.
Yeah, so I heard my boy Jonathan say a long time ago, he sent me an article that said, as brilliant as the human mind is, right? And we talked about it before, Karl. What is it, 40,000 thoughts?
Thoughts.
Yeah. Was 40,000 thoughts per what?
I think it was per minute or something like that. Keep talking. I'll just look it up.
So I'm just saying, but I'm saying that's powerful. So you're saying 40,000 thoughts in 60 seconds, right? Watch this though, Karl. This is deep. He said, but the mind is not able to have two of those thoughts at the same time.
Sorry, it's 60 to 80,000 per day. My apologies.
60 to 80,000, Karl, thoughts per day. But the mind is not capable of having two of those thoughts at one time. You feel me? 60 to 80,000 thoughts, but you only one at a time. So when you're thinking about jumping, you cannot jump. because you're thinking about jumping. The brain can't do that. It's not capable of doing that. The brain won't let you do it like that. The brain might be like, you might be trying to go all over the place. I'm not doing that. I'm going to give you one at a time. So which one are we doing right now? Okay, we're not jumping right now. Okay, body, we're not jumping. Legs, don't move. Arms, don't move. We're not jumping. But if you go jump, then the brain go, hey, y'all. Hey, guess what, guys? We jumping. You feel me? We jumping. Let's jump. You feel me, Karl? So that's the problem right there is you're doing too much. Focus on what? One thing. What's that? Everything it takes to get what you need to get done, done. Don't concentrate on nothing else. You feel me? Don't concentrate on nothing else, Karl. So, like, to C's point, when I got the building, bruh, when you talk about my heart sunk in my stomach when Didi said, nope, we got to knock the second floor off. I was like, do you know how much more time that's going to take? Do you understand when you say knock the floor off that we're not going to be able to do that? That we're going to have to bring somebody in? And anytime you have to bring somebody else in, do you understand how much more time that is? We're going to talk about that next week when we talk about why you guys can't execute. And so for me, Karl, I made up in my mind the next level of growth for us will come from us having a building, because the only way to get the masses behind us is to have a place for them to come. You know what I'm saying? I was like, C and I, same thought process, but of course we go about doing it different. When C was like, E, bro, you don't need to be working like that no more, like unless you want to. I said the same thing he said. It was like, if I can get a building with 450 people in this joint, Karl, I can just come from my house and work. I don't have to get on the road no more and do work I don't want to do. And I don't have to go spend money on a hotel to do a conference. Like, people who really want to be trained, not just some like conference stuff, but they want to really go through what I call the extreme execution boost camp. You feel me? I call it the boost camp. Why? Because I'm trying to boost you, bro. Like, that's what I do. And so the doors are open, Karl. Somebody called me up there. E, when we going to open it? I said, as soon as the C's think it's time, because the curriculum has been planted, the sound system is ready, the projectors are ready, the chairs are in there, the floor is laid, the carpet is laid. Let's go. So
just people left.
Yeah, so I'm saying to everybody out there, full throttle. That's it. Like, for real, stop playing. Biggie said, 160. I just keep remembering Biggie saying, do run, 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 do run, run. He said that sucker go 160. I'm saying, let's put the pedal to the metal. No more. And not at Karl on it. It's like, yo, no more hesitation. No more hesitation. No more, all right, let's think this thing through. No, full throttle, full speed ahead. And so for those of you listening, I just want to add to C, full speed ahead. For real, stop 60, 120, you back to 70. I always learn, if you're going to drive long distance, if you're going to do 80, do 80. Don't do 80, then 60, and then 50. And if you're going to do 80 all the way. So that's my thing. But like I said, I was so hurt when Diddy said the high ceilings, because I knew it was going to take so much. And to C's point, as we continue to go and the momentum went, 16 acres, y'all. You understand? The trees that for 2 years this property sat, we had trees, we had weeds, we had grass. And once we got going, guess what people saw? Oh, they going? Oh, I'm retired. I'll come. I got equipment. I'll knock all the trees down for them. Oh, I got it. Oh, they doing high ceiling? Oh, we'll come in and do the high ceilings for them. Oh, they need drywall? Oh, we'll do it for less than 50% of what everybody else is doing. Oh, they need paint? Oh, we're going to come and paint the outside of the thing for them. We normally charge thousands of paint. We'll do everything for $700. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? To see
E, give me this, E. Give me this real quick. Is this the first property that we looked at?
This is not the first property we looked at, Karl.
Because I want people to still understand that this is still a process.
Absolutely, like, it's not the first property.
How long ago were we looking for properties?
We was probably looking for properties for about six months maybe before I found this one.
I just want people to hear that. Like, it ain't something that just happened. Like, it ain't no wishing on a star. It was grind.
And the church was, there were members, Karl, pissed because they thought other properties we saw, I should have went for those.
Yeah, yeah.
And I said, let me be, look,
let me drive this thing. I got y'all. They was rushing, Karl. We borrowing other people's stuff. We don't have our own baptism pool. We don't have a place to eat. After church, we cannot fellowship. We gotta go straight home afterwards. I said, ho, 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 now. And bruh, this property, 16 acres. It's kind of like by itself. We had Karl, we had a tent, three tent set up yesterday. Like we was doing like a circus. And guess what? It didn't take up a piece. We had a full court dog on basketball. That basketball thing didn't take up a piece. We had the bouncy house. We still had a diamond to play kickball, a full diamond to play kickball. And Karl, that was only a third of the space. We were only on the beginning of the property. We weren't even in the middle or in the back where the soccer field is. So yeah, man, for those of you who are out there listening, C said something deep. I want to reiterate, not the vehicle. What do you really want? And Karl said, he said he ain't going to preach. But if your mind can think it, it's only because you have the capacity to do it.
My. You know what else you got the capacity to do?
Drink Organifi.
What's that, C? Tell me.
Shout out to Organifi, man, our sponsor. The Superfood Green Juice Powder, man, that the whole crew's been rocking with. Y'all know it. Y'all hear it every week on the podcast. They've been a loyal, faithful sponsor to us. And so we want to be a loyal, faithful, sponsor to them, right? And show them, that we value them, man, by telling you guys about Organifi. Organifi.com, promo code SUCCESS. All right, you're going to get 20% off your order. And, man, we've got so many repeat orders. I just, of course, I'm at my folks' crib. I see they got the Organifi in the cupboard stacked, pops on it on a rag. I'm not sure if mom's on it yet, but she will be soon. And, man, we rock with Organifi super heavy. So go check them out, man. Make sure you get healthy, man. You know what I mean? Do something for yourself, man, to get healthy. For those of you who, are trying to get to that next level with, your health and, taking it serious, man, this is a great supplement to help you do so. So for, again, O-R-G-A-N-I-F-I.com, Organifi.com. Promo code SUCCESS is going to get that to you a little cheaper. So real quick.
All right, let me get HelloFresh in there real quick. We've been rocking with them for a while as well, man. And we just want to shout them out. HelloFresh makes cooking delicious meals at home a reality, regardless of your comfort level in the kitchen. From step-by-step recipes to pre-measured ingredients, you'll have everything you need to get a wow-worthy dinner on the table in just about 30 minutes. Say goodbye to the grocery store and fast food forever. HelloFresh has got your back. There's something for everyone, from the family recipes to calorie smart and vegetarian recipes. And then there's the fun menu series like the Hall of Fame and Kraft Burgers. Whatever it is, HelloFresh has got you covered. They got more 5-star recipes than any other meal kit, so you know you'll get something delicious. You guys heard me talk about being in Barbados for this whole month. Like, we were able to schedule, our delivery so it would come right in time for us to go. That's hectic as ever, just before you leave, trying to get everything prepared. But we had the cheddar crusted chicken with buttery mashed potatoes and roasted broccoli. And then the other one we had that my kids loved was the sweet and smoky chicken cutlets. And it came with a cherry ancho barbecue sauce, green beans, and pineapple rice. I don't know the last time y'all cooked like that, but man, my family enjoyed it. So hey, for $80 off your first month of HelloFresh, go to HelloFresh.com/success80. And use that same promo code, SUCCESS80. Once again, for $80 off your first month of HelloFresh, go to HelloFresh.com/success80 and use the promo code SUCCESS80, SUCCESS80.
Oh, I got the HelloFresh. Shout out to HelloFresh too, man.
You got theirs? Yeah, I had my last week, man, again. Yeah.
We had the cheesy chicken enchiladas. Oh my goodness. HelloFresh, man. For those of you, for real, man, you hear Karl do the read. For those of you out there and you might be a little incapable or just not quite, the skilled chef you need to be, HelloFresh is the biggest cheat code ever. Like ever. Like, yo, you literally cannot mess it up. They give you exactly the right amount. They give you the exact ingredients and like it is step by step. And I promise you, it will have you making dishes that your family will be like, yo, there's no way you cook this. And I'm going to be real. I was skeptical at first when we started with HelloFresh because I'm like, yo, they about to send this stuff through. It's about to be bland. You know what I mean?
Right,
it's not,
right,
not going to be not you know, at all. Rich. Bro, I promise you, the flavors are incredible. Jamal, I know Marl and Camille, his family, they use it like 3-4 times a week.
Hey.
I know the girls cook it. It is incredible. So shout out to HelloFresh, too.
Marshall texted me this week, and Marshall's like, yo, you just messed up on one thing. I was like, what's up? He's like, I've been rocking with y'all. I started doing the HelloFresh, and he's like, bruh, me and my wife started doing it together. We had a blast. But he's like, what happened by the third time I got it is that my wife no longer in the kitchen. He said, now she realized that it's something so simple that I could do it on my own. He's like, yo, she left me on the solo. Now I'm preparing dinner for the family, and she upstairs. He said, she upstairs taking a nap while I'm cooking. He's like, you did not let me know that part. So, yeah, no.
Yeah, no question. Give him our promo code for HelloFresh.
So HelloFresh.com and use the promo code SUCCESS80, SUCCESS80.
Oh, I sent y'all videos, man. Teaching Trey how to ride his bike has been a great feeling. Karl, I text you the video, but yeah, man, it's so funny, man. Life does really come full circle. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, I'm literally teaching him to ride a bike on the exact same sidewalk that I learned how to ride a bike. So that's what I was doing right before I came here. I sent E a video, sent Karl a video, let him see it, man. I'll maybe post a video on the S2S page as well, but was at my parents' house, man. They got a straight runway. I don't know, my house some kind of way has got like a big hill. It's like, you know, a slant. So it's been hard to teach him on that. But man, he took the training wheels off and went for it, man. And you know, people talk about, you know what's so funny? I never actually taught anybody to ride a bike, but all of the like metaphors that they use for life and riding a bike are like so true.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? Like,
yes, sir.
Yo, like literally, like Karl, like he fell off. My man rode into the bushes about 5 times. Like he hurt his toe, literally tore the skin off his toe some kind of way.
Mm.
Bruh, he has been banged, injured. Of course, you know, we got the helmet on. I don't think we had helmets back in the day, but he got a helmet on. His mama just bought him knee pads, arm pads, elbow pads. I said, "Babe, okay, you killing the whole learning experience." But Karl, my man literally fell off. I mean, you can imagine. You fall off the bike every time. And, you know, I let him keep going. Day 2 was today, and he riding that thing. So, you know, when they say, you know, you fall off, get right back on, man, I told him. He was like, bro, I ran. He's like, Dad, I just rode into all the bushes. I scratched every part of my body. I said, that's all right, son, get back on. And he making it happen, man. So proud dad. That ain't had nothing to do with the podcast. Just a proud dad moment.
Hey, no. See, don't stop. I'm saying it has everything to do with the podcast. Because the one thing that I told Jordan, in line with what he just said, the one thing I told Jordan to teach him how to ride was, you have to go faster.
Mm. Yep, that's true.
You have to go faster. You can't ride slow and balance. Mm-mm. It just ain't gonna happen. Ooh. So I was like, dude, when you get on here, pedal like you about to die. Like, I'm gonna put everything into pedaling. And I promise you, see, I mean, he was riding with a trainer. He was crazy before. But Ian, funny enough, it happened right on that hill at the front of the church. See, so you come outside and turn to your left going down that hill. Jordan learned to ride right on that hill. And the reason I made him go down, it's not a big, big hill, y'all, but it's enough to, again, keep him going faster than he was comfortable. And I promise you, the third time going down that hill from then, he's never put the bike down. So you got to go faster, even with the bike analogy, see, so it tied in perfectly.
Oh, yeah, no question, because let me tell you something. You try to go slow, that front, hold on, Karl, how deep you want to go? How deep you want to go?
How
much time we got?
Let's go.
Hold on. How about I told Trey, bruh, the reason you keep falling is because you're looking straight at the front of the tire. You got to look straight out ahead of you and see where you want to go.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. I'm like, dog, you can't look at where by the time you're looking at your tire, where you looking down at the ground, you already passed it.
Yep.
And so you messing yourself up because you're looking at something that's not real. I'm like, yo, look out to where you want to go. And so you know what I did? He kept, like I said, he kept falling off. And my dad was like, yo, he looking down. And so what I did was I ran all the way down the whole block. And I said, this is where I want you looking the whole time you riding it. So he looked up, head up, looking straight at the target, and he hit it. So enough of the cheesy bike metaphors, you know what I'm saying? There was a million of them as I'm sitting there, but yeah, we a little deeper than that. So we're gonna back away from that and tell you guys about some of the things that we have coming up as a company. Karl, I know you on a semi vacation, so if you don't have them ready, I forgive you.
Oh, but. I got them. We ready. Verified conference, y'all. August 9th, the City of Brotherly Love. We coming to you. We coming deep. We coming with the QDZ, the one and only QDZ, shutting it down on all media, airwaves, TV. You can find QDZ everywhere. Toby. Y'all, I ain't got to get Toby no introduction. Willie Moore Jr., and y'all might not know, but check her out. Karen Civil. Like, y'all got to check her out. This is an all-star cast, and of course, y'all know the rest of us going to be there. The hip-hop preacher is still our headline act, man. So August 9th, Verified. If you want to be, and think of that name. We're not playing with the name. Verified. You already have a gift. You already have a talent. If you're ready to put that thing to work, man, and get it out to the world, this is your opportunity. Like, you want to be at that conference. So August 9th. And of course, we've been rocking the 1% tour, man. We're coming to New York August 23rd and 24th, New Orleans September 12th and 13th, and DC October 5th and 6th. Y'all gonna hear about it every week up until then. The 1% featuring our very own E.T. the Hip Hop Preacher, Mr. Jamal King, and Tiffany. Y'all don't sleep on Tiffany. Tiffany is killing it out here. That's the conference that C mentioned earlier with the Millions conference she did this weekend. She'll be at our event as well. And let me tell y'all, from those people that were in Chicago, y'all been there, y'all seen it. Like, for real, bring a friend. Like, do not miss this. So again, New York, August 23rd, 24th, New Orleans, September 12th and 13th, and DC, October 5th and 6th. And then last but not least, next year, April 25th to May 1st, 2020, the year 2020, y'all, we planning it a year out so you can make sure you put them pennies aside. We're going to Mexico with the Phenomenal Life 2020. You do not want to miss it. Like I said, everything that we do happens there. All our fun, all our intensity, a lot of planning, a lot of vacation, a lot of, man, everything that you want. We're doing it all together, man. We got, we bring the crew out. We bring Sean out to do the health stuff. We bring Rob out. We're talking finances, Jamal, the real estate. Like, we bring everybody in our circle out, man. So you get the full Monty, man. So you do not want to miss that. Again, April 25th to May 1st, Riviera Maya in Mexico. So.
Hey, Karl, you ain't lost a step on them announcements out there in the dose. I thought, you know what saying? When you out there drinking mojitos and putting your toes in the sand, you know, I thought you might have slipped, but that sounded pretty good.
We still here.
Yeah, no doubt, man. I still got to get out to the dose. I never been, but, you know, maybe one day, you know, I start living on the left side.
Hey, he said I got to have a property, so that just put the chance. It's no on me question. Now. I got to have a place for y'all to come. So it's
no
on me
question.
Now.
Yeah, no question. Hip-hop preacher, we're going to, I told you, the rice. We're going to get you the rice. Ooh. Rest, ice, compress, elevate.
Elevate,
repeat. You know what I'm saying? Dr. Thomas is over here. I pulled up, bro. I promise you, I pulled up to the church. He was trying to get up them steps with one foot. I said, and I knew yesterday, me and Maul was standing on the side. Maul and Tommy drove up for the church retreat, and I seen E rounding them bases, and I said, this cannot be good for the swelling of the knee. And sure enough, I pulled up today. He said, hey, because he saw me with the ace bandage. He said, hey, go and bring that ace bandage that you had ace. And come through. Ace is the place for hardware. You know what I'm saying? Bro, I'm about hitting up, you know, that later stage. Yeah. Well, and I had a couple of surgeries on my knee, so yeah. I already knew I was through, Karl. But, yeah, the other message of the day is know your limitations. No. He said,
Don't go
east and west. Another metaphor. You going side to side. It go forward, north and south. He ain't never heard himself jogging at 5.0 on a treadmill. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't until he tried to be the kickball legend that he actually got hurt. So, that's it. And E, give us a nugget of the day. We'll be back next week, man, with a full-length podcast. I feel the hate mail come in when we stop a little short. You know, we might be getting some hate mail, but we'll be back with the full-length podcast for next week. But E, why don't you Kawhi, real quick, can we just talk about it, because I don't want it to get too far away. My thoughts on that, man, you know, I respect it. You know, Josh and I were texting, and I was like, yo, I respect it. Like, instead of joining the super team, he could have went to LA with AD and LeBron and did his thing. My man was like, nah, I want to even it out. So him and Paul George, you know, I feel bad for Westbrook, but him and Paul George.
Right.
Bruh, I cannot remember a time, and Karl, you're a historian of the hoops as well. I cannot remember a time where the NBA seemed to be so wide open for who was going to win the championship. Yep. You know what I mean? Yep. Like, usually every year you kind of know, like, okay, Golden State, they had a run. Yep. You know, LeBron doing his thing with the Heat. You know, the Bulls, you had, you know, the Lakers, the Celtics. You have all these dynasties. And, I mean, we're going into this next year. And I honestly couldn't tell you who is the favorite to win it all. So, Karl, you got your Lakers almost got it, but they missed Kawhi.
Help me though. See, hey Karl, hold on. I gotta ask you this question because I didn't know the Clippers was like, you know, Frank Long, that's my dude, but I ain't know the Clippers was this deep. Why is that?
You know what? So no, here's the crazy thing: is not only the Clippers this deep. Think about this: the Nets and the Clippers beat out the Lakers and the Knicks.
And the Knicks.
Because you had KD and Kyrie go to the Nets instead of the Knicks. And you had Kawhi choose the Clippers instead of the Lakers. So, yeah, no, it's it's a good time to be, you know, slept on, you know, the underdog. So, go for it, Karl.
Hey, I was going to say, if I'll go on record saying, if Kawhi brings a championship to the Clippers, after doing it in Toronto, we got to have a real conversation.
We got to move Kawhi into the real conversation. Kawhi might already be. How many rings did he get with San Antonio? Two?
Either one or two. Yeah, one or two.
Oh, he definitely got more than one.
Yeah.
He got to have at least two with them, right? Might have got three. No, two.
So to go to the Clippers and just kind of rebuild.
This is a podcast. Why don't y'all act like we got Google? He's sitting there looking at me like, I think it's two with his phone in his hand. You know what I'm saying? This is how much we love the podcast, y'all. We just, you know what I'm saying? We just sitting up here and we got access to Google. But I think Kawhi at least got three rings now.
Karl gave his commentary on it.
Yeah, Karl said he thought that if Kawhi win with the Clippers.
Oh, no, that's it. Now I'm going to call Lawrence Frank up, though, for real, and be like, bruh, I missed the opportunity with the Raptors. I did. But I don't want to miss this one. And not only Karl miss it from a basketball standpoint, from a leader standpoint, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to grow my leadership. I'd really like to sit down with Lawrence Frank and just kind of pick his brain on, you know, just the whole leadership piece. Like what, you know, how do they set this up, whatever. So I'm excited, bro. Like, unless our relationship is falling off, Lawrence, Adam, Frank, has our relationship fallen off? If it hadn't fallen off, Karl, I'm gonna ask for the opportunity, seriously. You know me, I don't really do games like that, but.
It's the second seed. It was one with San Antonio 2014 when they beat Miami 4-1.
So he only won when he beat LeBron.
Yeah.
And when he beat LeBron, and then this one that he
and
just
then
got.
This one.
We'll see what happens with his next one. But I just want to sit down and learn, you know. And I have to keep saying this. It's the gift that keep on giving. Remember when I got left in Detroit because I was with my man? I always wondered what would come of this relationship. You know what I'm saying, Karl? Yeah. Like, was it worth me staying? And it has definitely been worth me sticking around. So, yeah, I'm going to definitely, man, by God's grace, take advantage of this opportunity, man. You know, of course, that's where we met CP3. And, you know, so, yeah, man, this is I don't know. I don't know. I'm still favoring the Lakers, to be honest with you. I'm still because they picked up Cousins. Is that right? See, they picked up Cousins for a year.
Yeah.
Got Cousins for a year. Then Green. They got Green. Green. They got Green. So I'm thinking, Karl, with Danny Green, Cousins.
It's a squad. It's a squad.
LeBron, AD, still got Rondo, and how you say Kuzma. They still got Kuzma. So I'm sure they're gonna get a cut. What's his name? I don't want to say it wrong. Man, don't kill me. He's gonna kill me if I say his name wrong. Pope.
Oh, Caldwell Pope.
KCP. Yeah. So I think they a little bit more, you know, I don't know basketball like C. So like I said, I don't know what the Clippers working with that I don't know. I just keep hearing they got the best defense right now in the league. So we'll see what that means exactly. All right. All right. Well, Karl didn't have a comment for me. So
you're good. Yeah, that's it.
How do you know when you ain't waxing deep?
Like C said, it's just wide open, E. Like, it ain't no predictions, huh?
Yeah, I said, how do you know when you're not waxing deep when it's just silent? Yes. You know what I'm saying? He's sitting up there like, they got what's his name? Pope. And they also got what's his name? Rhonda. You know what I'm saying? You have been officially demoted from Sports Talk Radio. Hey, get your nugget of the day ready. Shut up. we're gonna let E get the nugget of the day. We're gonna go over there, man, and check on D and make sure she's good, man. We gotta get that, that rice. Hey, today. Today, the word, as a matter of fact, Karl, that's the name of the podcast.
Got it.
Rest, ice, compress, elevate. Okay, rice. That's only for y'all over 35, okay? Right. Y'all under 35, don't worry about rice yet. You ain't at that level.
Just been gay.
Just been gay. He literally was rubbing some, what was you rubbing on your leg?
TJ gave me something, I don't even know what it was. It didn't work though. Whatever it was, it didn't work.
Give us that nugget of the day.
Hey, man. Y'all, tear it down. Don't be afraid to tear it down. A lot of you are afraid to tear it down, but you heard me. The first thing, well, you heard C, the first thing we had to do before we can get the building where we wanted it is to tear it down. And some of you are so afraid to tear it down because you think if you tear it down, it'll never grow. You know what I'm saying? You'll feel like you will never get back to that spot that you were at. Tear it down. And tear it down with joy. Tear that sucker down. I'm talking about with excitement. Be geeked up about tearing it down. Knowing that when you tear that sucker down and level it to the ground and build back up, that you're going to build something phenomenal. So don't be afraid to tear it down. Tear it down, my friend.
Hey, Karl, enjoy the Barbados, man. Love to the family. Love to everybody out there listening. We'll see you next week.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.